I was having with Claude and Nathaniel, and also what they meant for me for many years after leaving the center, and also the history and the knowledge and all of the work that I had been a part of, and also where I'm at now and growing in the community as well. So this poem that I have is called Scars. They don't ask how my stomach feels when the food I've consumed wouldn't even be served to kettle, or the lack of color on my skin is composed from the lack of sunlight, and the lacerations on my chest are from the guard's batons. I haven't felt my daughter's skin since she was a newborn, and these shoulders haven't been touched by another in so long. And they don't wake me up by the sound of Frederick Payer, but the echoes of coughing and yakking are soundtracks in here. And I've been up for hours, gazing at the stars and the moon's view, and it's being blocked out by metal bars, laying down with nothing but the clothes on my back that saves my flesh from the ice cold concrete floor. And the faces of the ones I love have become vague memories of faceless faces and voiceless voices, and it all comes and goes in and out like the wind. Their bodies hang over my head like a noose, and we haven't seen them or hear them. And I've learned that the deepest thoughts are not what's in my head, but rather what's in my heart. And I've convinced myself that my country needs me, but the reality is I need her first. And these prison walls have proved otherwise. And my brothers are wrapped in white and buried beneath my feet. And my grandma prays for me because she believes in the God that believes in this. And I've realized that the dunya for the believer is a prison. And my concept for my demise in prison is only obsolete, but the mentality or the physicality of where your heart goes, and when your mind is liberated, how much can your heart actually capture? And is your body a part of that that is captured? And does it become trapped between the fight to live or the right to die? And my hands have faded into the darkness of the abyss, and I bring them to my knees, and my knees hit the floor, and I bend over with my chest supplicated, and my head bows to sujood, and my eternal self becomes like clay and water, and my third eye prevails, and the scene becomes clear as water. My birth from Naima's womb is a stepping stone to the liberation of my tomb. Thank you.